Yo, what up? It's your boy Iflowz Ent, the official press. I'm here with episode number 7, Cattown. What's up, man? Tell us who you are. Where you from?
Yeah, it's your boy Cattown, you know what I'm saying? From the west side of Charlotte. You know, CEO of Young South Entertainment. You already know what the fuck going on around here, you know what I'm saying?
Already. So, my name is Iflowz. What I do, I go around. I've been a journalist since 2018. I've been a vlogging artist and interviews on talent that I think should be highlighted and I see as next to break. And I'm happy to have you in episode number 7. And I want to get to know a little bit more about you, like who inspires you to do music and what is your style? Like, what would you call your style of music?
Well, you know, my cousin, you know what I'm saying, King Carter, he inspired me to do music. You know, he was, you know, at first, you know, so I used to play basketball, you know what I'm saying, high school or whatever like that. And then my cousins always be around me and stuff like that, be rapping all the time, had talent shows and stuff like that. And I be like, damn, he got damn serious about this music shit, you know what I'm saying? I was looking at it like, whatever, you know what I'm saying? Just listening to music, I'm like, this shit be dope, you know what I'm saying? But I ain't never thought I'd be doing music,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He did it so much.
How did it get into you, like? Music, for it to come out of you.
Man, mostly listen to the people I came up with. You know, I listened to like Tupac, okay. Soulja Slim, and you know, they were spitting their story, how they feel and their emotions and what they was going through and what they seen in the streets and stuff like that. So I was like, well, let me try this, you know what I'm saying, to see if I can do this and see if people will feel me, if it'll work. If it don't work and people don't feel me, I ain't gonna do it, you know what I'm saying? I'll step and do something else.
So with that being said, how would you describe the sound that you make?
I make like I'm more like a southern street storyteller, you know. I won't consider myself a poetry writer, right, like that. I'd write whatever come to my heart or whatever I've been around or whatever I did or what I experienced in the streets, you know.
What's the process like?
Process, it. Long nights. Some days you want to give up. Like, I be riding in my car, be like, you know what I'm saying, just listening to beats.
Yeah.
Like, man, I got to do this all over again. It's like...
But you've been doing this for a while.
Yeah. I've been doing it for about... I took it serious in like, I could say 05, 06, yeah. When we had a group, I started taking it serious, you know. Mm-hmm. I was never letting, you know what I'm saying, everybody around me know what I had going on, you know what I'm saying. So I always used to branch off and do my own thing.
Right.
So you know what I'm saying? And I don't think people really realize that my people I did, you know what I'm saying, music with, I call them my family, my brothers or whatever like that, because I grew up with them since, you know what I'm saying, they was young, like 12, 13. So I never really let them know, you know what I'm saying, what I had going on, what I was planning to do with my music, you know. I would just sit back and just analyze stuff, you know what I'm saying? I learned a lot analyzing my cousin, King Carter and stuff. It taught me a lot how to move and stuff like that. How do you know what I'm saying?
So it sounds like either you don't work with other artists or you limit what artists you work with. So who have you worked with and who would you be willing to work with?
I don't work with a lot of artists in Charlotte. And I'm willing to work with who are willing to work with me, you know. I be so busy working and worrying about my own team, I reach out to somebody, you know what I'm saying, say, I want to work with you and stuff like that. But really, I know at that time, I really can't work with that person, but I really want to work with them. I like to, you know what I'm saying, get my craft up more, get it at a higher level, really before I holler at somebody about doing something, you know. Or if I see somebody that's working real good and they talented, I reach out to them, you know what I'm saying. I let them know, you know, I'm looking at you, you know what I'm saying. So keep up the good work.
Who do you represent now? Like, what's your position with your company?
I'm the CEO of Young South Entertainment. My cousin, he was CEO of Young South Entertainment, the old Young South Entertainment. Now it's the new Young South Entertainment. So now it's like I'm taking everything in my own hands.
Who's in this camp?
I got 30 G's. I got Sir Smoke, Young Cup, and I'm looking for a young talent right now, like 17, 18, you know.
So you juggle a lot, being between you are an artist,
yeah,
but you also represent artists.
Yeah,
what
yeah.
What does that
yeah.
feel like? What is that Man. Responsibility like?
It's really hard, I ain't gonna lie, because, you know, I want to make sure, you know what I'm saying, I'm not stepping on my artist's toes, you know what I'm saying, I'm not in the way,
right?
You know what I'm saying?
You're
so,
artist,
yeah, yeah, so
even though we know that each artist has their own separate fan base,
mm-hmm.
it can fans can vary. People that like you might like somebody else, but you're who they favor, or the next guy is who they favor to.
Yeah.
How does that make you feel?
I mean, I don't care. As long as everybody working, that's all that matters to me. And then, you know, I'm the type of person, you know what I'm saying? I'm a passionate person that push people. Like, if I see something in you, I'm going to push it to the limit. You know what I'm saying? Even though you might not want to do it or you think you ain't got it. If I see something in you, I'm going to push it. Regardless of what somebody else say, I don't care if they be like, I don't really like his music like that. I think you should push this other person in your camp. No, I'm pushing everybody. It's not no just one particular person I'm focused on. You know what I'm saying? Even though if that person's talent is better than theirs, but their talent might reach another fan base that your talent don't.
So is it only Charlotte for you, or have you guys expanded beyond Charlotte?
I expanded beyond Charlotte. I had two South Carolina artists, K Cope and Moan G, and you know they got a good fan base out there in South Carolina. So I have expanded, though. I mostly been keeping it mostly in Carolina, but the only artist I got right now, he's from the A, is Sir Smoke, but he been staying in Charlotte for like 8-9 years. So I always tell him, you know what I'm saying, when you with me, you can talk about the A, but you got to keep that Charlotte in there too, because you know what I'm saying, you got to keep that Carolina wave in there, you know what I'm saying. I try to make it so Carolina as most I can.
So let's say you get a phone call. What's your latest single right now? What are you bumping right now? What's Cattown bumping right now? What are you performing?
Well, my recent mixtape that came out this year was Hustler / Entrepreneur, and I'm bumping that PSA.
Okay.
It's produced by Young Ice.
Okay, so let's say you get a call from Cali to open up at the awards at PSA. Who are you expecting to open up for?
That's a good question. If I open up somebody, it's got to be somebody that I listen to and look up to. I say it could be somebody right now that I listen to. I like
travel all the way to California to open up at the award show.
Oh, right now if I open for the award show. Oh, I had to keep it with right now. You know what I'm saying? Carolina, ain't gonna lie. I say right now, the baby. I say let me see. The artists that I like, they don't really be like at the war show. They should be, you know what I'm saying. I like Pooh Shiesty. You know what I'm saying. He's starting to get up there now, and I like Fredo Bangs. My cousin put me on him, Strap. So it's like, I mostly like those underground rappers that might not be at the war show. You might not see them like that. You know what I'm saying. So right now it's kind of hard to answer that, because you know what I'm saying, the people I listen to, I don't think they're gonna be at the war show. And I like, if I did, it'd probably be like, I say right now, I like, I'm trying to think who really up there hot, because they just had the BET Awards, and I ain't really to see nobody that I probably would want to open up for, unless it's somebody I like. I ain't even gonna lie.
I feel you. I get that. I understand. So I got a question for you. What's your message for fans? What do you want people to walk away with from this? Like, what do you want people to know about you?
My message before I leave away from this, I just want people, you know what I'm saying, to chase their dreams. Don't ever give up, you know, because you can get distracted. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes I done got distracted and got angry at myself. Sometimes I don't be liking myself because I feel like I could have did more. or I feel like sometimes I feel like I ain't giving enough. It just I just feel like I haven't reached the level that where I could say, yeah, they gonna write Cattown name on the wall in Charlotte. That's why I'm trying to get level at, you know what I'm saying? Like a Nipsey Hussle type of stuff, you know what I'm saying? Even though he did a lot of stuff, you know what I'm saying? My main thing is mostly music, you know what I'm saying? But I could do other things besides music, you know what I'm saying?
Absolutely. So, if you're anything like me, and your wife gets upset when you forget to take out the trash, what would you say is your most useless talent you have?
If I get to take out the trash?
If you're anything like me and you forget to take out the trash, that's my most useless talent. Other than that, what would you say is your most useless talent?
Most useless talent. Cooking. I can't cook. I ain't gonna lie. I cook breakfast. Dinner.
What kind of breakfast you cooking the next morning after you bring her home from the club and y'all done woke up?
I'm in there dabbling. I go in there with the eggs, bacon, and everything. You know what I'm saying? I ain't that raw with the grits. You know what I'm saying? I think I be putting too much water in that thing. You know what I'm saying? So sometimes I had to let my wife deal with that. I try. You know what I'm saying? As long as I'm trying, that's all that matters to me.
Alright, so your wife busts into the bathroom while you're in the shower. Are you singing in the shower?
I don't be singing. I'll be rapping, yeah, because I only time, if you ever catch me singing, I'll be listening to Rod Wave. That's the only thing that make you sing or something like that, you know what I'm saying? Before
what
that,
song,
though.
What song by Rod Wave?
What's one I like? Life of a Soldier. I like that because, you know, Soulja Slim, one of my favorite artists. So anytime somebody talk about Soulja Slim, that's a light for me already. You know what I'm saying? Anything you say about him in your lyrics, oh yeah, I'm fucking with you. So yeah, Life of a Soldier.
So if it wasn't for your music career right now, what would you be doing?
I ain't right now what I be doing. Well, definitely ain't gonna be probably no basketball. I'll probably be spending whole lot of more time with my family, because I know sometimes when I come home and stuff like that, I know they be missing me and stuff like that, because they know I take the music stuff serious. So I feel like, you know, my wife be on my neck sometimes too, so you know what I'm saying, you need to do something with me, like, then I know I, you know what I'm saying, I sometimes go overboard with the music stuff. So family time.
You say life as an indie artist is pretty busy.
Yes, yeah, it'll take up your time, and sometimes the person you with might not understand, you know, because they don't see your vision of what you're trying to do, you know.
And that's an even bigger toll, because you not only balance your career, but other careers,
yeah,
while balancing a committed relationship.
Yeah. That's a lot. Man, that's a lot, man. It's like, you got to hear it all the time.
So does your family come to see you at your performances? Like,
yep,
where
yep
do you perform?
I just performed at Montego Studios. Well, you know, since the pandemic went on, you know what I'm saying, I ain't really performed. But before then, I performed at my boy Shiesty Woods. He threw something. I performed at CIAA. I performed at Onyx, White House. I mostly tried anywhere DJ Chuck T be at. I mostly try to get where he at, cause he
shout
my favorite DJ. Yeah,
King.
Yeah, he my DJ. Yeah, he gonna let you know. You know what I'm saying? I send him some music. He let me know quick. A like Cat, I love you. And I love you on South Entertainment, but this ain't it. I was like, Chuck, you give me a hard time. Hey, but I like that though, cause that keep me motivated to keep on making some music. Cause eventually, if I keep on sending him something, he gonna like something.
That's what, you know, consistency.
Yeah,
is key in this business. And since you mentioned the pandemic, a lot of artists have to be consistent in other departments. So now that we're in the digital age with music, how do you feel the internet has impacted music for you?
I feel like it's been a plus and it's been a negative. I say it's been a negative because you can't get out to your people, you know what I'm saying, let you see perform. They ain't seen you in a minute and stuff like that, you know. And you know what I'm saying? Because I was kind of rusty when we performed last week. I don't know, man. Do I still got it? And I get up there, you know what I'm saying?
What's your favorite song to perform?
Right now.
That you felt would have helped you through that rusty moment. What's your favorite song?
I should have did my legendary song, West Side. But we was on the East. And the songs we were already doing, I'm already saying West Side in them. So it's like, that's why I did that song, West Side, you know what I'm saying? I did it 3 years ago, you know what I'm saying? That song really pushed me out there. It got me out there to the people, you know. Oh, he telling a story about the west side of Charlotte. So once I got that out, they knew where I was coming from. So it wasn't no point in me to keep doing that song because they already know I'm from the west side, so.
Or it could be another artist. Mm-hmm. But who do you admire as an artist?
As an artist, right now, or it doesn't matter?
Doesn't matter.
I'm not an artist right now.
Cause today's time, we're about four generations mixed in.
Yeah.
Baby boomers, Gen X, millennials, Gen Z, and then we have another generation coming up. It's really. Are you political? Are you into political
debate?
Are you Trump?
I ain't really into that. I ain't really into political stuff, but I'm definitely a Democrat. So I definitely ain't no Trump, so you can go ahead and kill that. But an artist, I'm trying to think, will motivate me. I can say I can always go back and listen to it, Soulja Slim. But for right now, I played that Move Me, and I felt it slept on. My cousin got me on Fredo Bangs. I think a lot of people sleeping on him. I don't know why. You know what I'm saying? His first song off his new album. That thing, I'm telling you, that thing, he coming. But yeah, he really motivate me right now as far as like listening to music, because I can feel his struggle of like, I can feel what he going through. And the type of stuff he talking about, I can relate to. I know I can see myself saying some stuff he's saying, you know.
With that said, you're pretty busy nowadays, which is different from days you've had before. So what's the most trouble you've ever gotten into that you're comfortable to open up about?
What was the trouble I got into when I was young, when I was 17, and you know, I got caught with guns or whatever like that. Somebody tried to harm my brother. And you know what I'm saying? And I went to a basketball game and somebody, you know, they snitched on me. That's about it, you know. But I got those things dropped, so record clean. So now I'm back good now.
That's good to hear. That's definitely good to hear. Another brother got himself together, knows a little something about life, and is doing something with himself, first and foremost, for others, you know? And what would you say was the best advice that you received, and being that you lead a team right now?
Best advice I received?
What's the best advice you have given?
The best advice I done given to somebody is telling them, you know, you got to believe in yourself. Because if you don't believe in yourself, then you ain't going to make it. Even if you can rap good, you know what I'm saying? It's got to come in with themselves. And, you know, sometimes I be having that doubt. But I know I got to face my own fear. So eventually I'm going to shake out of it. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to come back. Okay, I'm ready. You know what I'm saying? But, getting advice from anybody else? Where have we gotten advice from? I think I got advice from, well, I get advice from, you know what I'm saying, the music I'm making and my artists. They give me advice, like, you know. Yeah, because they listen.
Who in the group gives you the best advice?
In my group to give me the best advice?
Who's in your ear most?
can give me a good advice? I can say Cup be giving me some good advice for like that.
Giving you bad advice. Yeah, I got to tell nobody
else. Nah, I ain't nobody. Nobody really gave me no bad advice for like that. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? 30 crazy. You know what I'm saying? But he ain't never gave me no bad advice for like that. I had to give him some advice. You know what I'm saying? But he ain't never gave me no bad advice. He ain't never said nothing negative, nothing like that. He just crazy.
So if there was anything you could change about the music industry, what would it be?
What I change about it, man, it just people, you know what I'm saying? They can rap good, but the stuff they talking about, they be lying about, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I understand now, you know what I'm saying? The type of people I listen to, you know what I'm saying? If you rapping about that, you had to be about it or somebody gonna, you know, check you. But now, you know what I'm saying? They don't care about that. They just care about popularity and you know what I'm saying? Who you know and, you know what I'm saying? Who you been around or whatever like that, what you done or clout chasing. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I wish you could change that back when, you know what I'm saying, Biggie and Tupac, that area. Or, you know what I'm saying, or that crump music area, you know what I'm saying, down south crump music, where you really had to show, like, if you bought this crump junk, we gonna see, you know what I'm saying? Like, No Limit and stuff like that, you know, just back in the good era, you know what I'm saying, early 2000s. But, you know, now they don't care about that no more. As long as you sound good on that mic, they don't care if you gangster, you ain't gangster. As long as you make good music. Now, you know, ain't nothing wrong with that, though, you know. Shoot, I'm in there with you. I'm trying to get some money, too.
Alrighty. So, what's next for you?
Right now, I haven't really... I just been featuring on my artist mixtape. So, the next... I probably won't drop nothing probably till next year. I probably start back in the booth probably, like, beginning of the year. You know what I'm saying? Because this pandemic drained me. Because we've been shooting videos. I just realized we done shot about 13 videos. I look back, I said, God damn, I ain't
busy with the other artists.
And then I had my artist Sir Smoke. He just finished his mixtape, Summertime. Then I had Young Cup. He just finished his mixtape. His just dropped today. So yeah, y'all need to go check that out. Young Cup, No Feeling. That shit goddamn straight up. That's my nigga. You know what I'm saying? So, and then we got 30 G's coming out with his One Shot, One Kill 2, Volume 2. And that's going to be a fool, too. So, we definitely working, you know what I'm saying? It just, I like to do everything in the pattern. Like, when somebody drops something, I like to, okay, it's your time to go next. So, I don't want to hear no crying about, you know what I'm saying? I ain't get to drop this deck, you know, because you got your span of time to make music, you know what I'm saying? Unless you got something going on with the family or something going on, you know. Didn't happen or whatever, like that's the only reason. But far as that though, well, I'm moving and working. So, and next for me, I'm probably dropping something next year's I don't really want to tell him. I go ahead and tell him. It's called Welcome to Charlotte. Welcome back to Charlotte. Because I already had Welcome to Charlotte. It's Welcome Back to Charlotte. And that thing gonna be a fool. I ain't gonna lie. I'm gonna have some different features on this one. It's gonna be kind of different. Still gonna be goddamn with that gutter shit, that West Side shit, you know what I'm saying? But I'm gonna be tapping in other spots, you know what I'm saying? I ain't tapped in on other mixtapes. So every mixtape I try to come out with, I try to make it different from the one previous one I came out with. So yeah, be looking out for them. You already know. And the niggas know in the city how I get down, you know what I'm saying? I'm just like Fred Joe Baines, you know what I'm saying? Really, people don't really speak about me like that, but they know when they see me in the building, oh yeah, that nigga Cattown here, they know you finna bring that West Side shit. See, I don't really be out like that. So when I do come on the scene, they know what time it is, you know what I'm saying?
Already. I appreciate you stepping out with me tonight, man.
That's what's up.
Turn it up with me for this episode number 7. It's all about you. So, real quick before we go in closing, tell us all how we can find you. Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, whatever you got, you name it.
I'm gonna say Twitter. I don't think I got up there yet. Yeah, you can look me on Instagram, Cattown Carter, Facebook, Cattown Carter. Anything you want to see, you want to find out about me, you can look up. You know what I'm saying? I got a fire ass video right now, PSA on YouTube right now. You know what I'm saying? And that shit go hard. You know what I'm saying? But make sure y'all go fuck with my nigga, Young Cup mixtape. I got it's Sir Smoke on there, 30 G's. You know what I'm saying? Jay Huey on there. Who else is on there? Montana, you know what I'm saying? But Young Cup, little group he got going on, Too Deep. Like, we working, bro. So be on the lookout for some new shit, because we ain't going to stop, bro. I know I got a lot of haters out there, but that's cool. But I don't give a fuck, bro. You already know. Fuck what they saying. And that's how I feel, you know what I'm saying? And shout out to everybody been fucking with me and everything, you know. We ain't gonna stop working. We there, and we gonna put our hope in God, beliefs in God, and we gonna keep grinding.
Yeah. I'm checking in live right now. It's that nigga Cattown, CEO of Young South Entertainment. If niggas got problems, holler at me, nigga. Don't go behind my artist's back talking bad about him, saying this and that, nigga.